Hi, it's John Terry with Vision Advisors, and welcome to another Selling Secret to the Top 5%. This is Selling Secret number 34, The Power of Podcasting. I want to take a few minutes and share really a 101 overview of podcasting and how the top 5% are effectively using this tool as an incredible resource that they can repurpose into a number of different marketing venues to engage with current clients, but also to engage with prospects and utilize the power of podcasting as a referral tool and resource. So really, when we're talking about podcasting, we're talking about a multi-purpose marketing tool that can be many, many faceted in its uses. Again, as I shared, it can be a tool that gets you in front of new opportunities with individuals that don't yet know who you are and what you do. It can be a very powerful tool to stay engaged and continue to build relationship with your existing clients. It can be a tool to introduce new conversations and new topics that your clients and those not yet your clients may be interested in and want to learn more about. The power of a podcast has really become one of the latest tools in the toolbox of the top 5% of all sales professionals in the marketplace. We're seeing, interestingly enough, in the financial services arena alone, a significant decrease in the number of financial professionals that are utilizing radio and television as a means to get in front of an audience. Now, while those are effective ways to do that, they are very, very expensive. But as we're seeing people drive less, where radio is more effective to catch people during drive time, and television, which has been a little more difficult, making sure you can catch people at a time they can actually watch a show on television. One of the nice things about a podcast is it's a 24/7 resource that's available at the click of a mouse, or unlike a live radio broadcast that they may catch only a few minutes, a podcast is something they can subscribe to. And once they subscribe to that, they can listen to that at their leisure. And every time a new episode is added to your channel, now they have an opportunity to be notified and to hear that, but also to be able to share that podcast with others. So what are some of the uses of a podcast? We're going to take a few minutes to touch on those, but let me highlight what we're going to cover here real quickly today. Number one, how to position yourself as an expert. Number two, how to use a podcast to stay connected with your clients. Number three, how to engage with and start new conversations. Number four, how to use a podcast as a referral source. Number five, how to use a podcast as a prospecting tool. And lastly, how to use a podcast to engage in what we call influence marketing. By the way, as you're listening to this, either on audio or watching on video, you're actually experiencing the power of a podcast as you are learning something new and valuable. And this is one of the ways that you can use a podcast as a tool to engage with your audience. So let's dive in and spend just a couple of minutes on each of these topics. So number one, a podcast can position you as an expert. As people have an opportunity to look at and to listen to your podcast that you're putting out there, either video, audio, or both, now you have an opportunity to be seen as an authority figure and as an expert as you are sharing your knowledge with your audience. Now, the nice thing about this is this allows those that don't yet know you to get to know you. And so when they have an opportunity to finally raise their hand and say, I want to learn more about who you are and what you do, the top 5% have utilized the power of a podcast to be seen as an authority figure, as an expert, but it also creates a sense of celebrity. Podcasting is one of the fastest growing areas of marketing in all industries, not just the financial services industry, but the top 5% have really gravitated to this because of the ability to leverage this expert status across multiple mediums online and to be able to share that in such a way that it becomes a dynamic, reusable tool that can really compel your existing audience to stay engaged, but invite new individuals in. So this really becomes part of your initial sales funnel to drive prospective customers deeper into your sales funnel, to move them to the point they're willing to say, I want an appointment to help me solve a money problem. I'll get that right in a minute. Now, secondly, it's an opportunity for you to stay connected with your clients. Remember, after you've had an opportunity to move a suspect and a prospect to say yes and buy from you, This is where a lot of the 95% of mediocre average sales professionals end the relationship. They forget that each customer has more than one money problem. And if you don't stay connected and continue to build relationship, you're treating that customer as a transaction. And your opportunity, if you don't continue to stay engaged in relationship with them, to have a second chance to solve another problem that they have, diminishes every week and every month you don't stay engaged. A podcast is simply another tool in your toolbox to make that happen. Your emails, your text messages, your newsletters, your phone calls, all of the outbounds that you do, postcards, letters, other things that you may send, a podcast simply becomes another connection point so that you're having an opportunity to live life with your customers, reminding them of why they did business with you in the first place. And that brings us to our next use of a podcast, and that's to start a new conversation. Your client may have come to you with a guaranteed income problem or a life insurance problem or a paycheck protection problem. And they may not realize there are other tools and resources that you have in your toolbox, other money problems that you can help them solve. Having conversation in your podcast about those financial topics and rotating through those on a regular basis, as life changes, your clients may discover that as they're leaving the workplace, they didn't realize that you helped them transition out of the workplace and move into retirement. They didn't realize that maybe you specialize in disability income, but you also have a program that can help them get out of debt in an average of 9 years or less, including their mortgage, and have an opportunity to save and enjoy a tax-free retirement as a result of that. Having those conversations and sharing those things that you do in and through a podcast can be a very powerful way to start a new conversation or to create a question in the client's mind. Do I need that? Do I have that? Or is this something I need to talk to that podcast host, i.e. you, about that particular conversation? Now, a podcast can serve as a very powerful referral source. Think about that. Your existing customers that already know you, like you, and trust you, you're using this tool to stay engaged, to continue to live life with them, to share with them in some fun segments of that podcast what's going on in your life with your family and having some personal time with them. And then as you share that resource with them by an email, by a text message, by posting it to your social media, putting it on your website, you're inviting them to stay engaged with you. But you also extend the opportunity to your existing customers to share this podcast with their friends, their neighbors, their family, their coworkers, other individuals that are in their inner circle that may have an interest in what you're sharing. Maybe they were playing golf with guys the other day, and one of the guys mentioned that he has a money problem that you just talked about in your podcast. They could share that podcast to introduce you as an available resource, and that individual has an opportunity to get to know you, like you, and trust you before he ever picks up the phone to schedule an appointment, which leads to the next use of podcasting, and that's as a prospecting tool. If you're actively marketing on social media or actively marketing offline, one of the areas that you can inform prospective clients that you have available as a free resource to give them knowledge, information, and insights so they can make better money decisions, and invite them to participate and be a subscriber to your podcast, now you are building credibility with them. You're building that know you, like you, trust you factor. I had a conversation today with a financial advisor that we work with that does an average of about $20 million a year in annuities. And as we were talking, he has a podcast that he puts out. And he was telling me, he said, John, between my podcast, my newsletter, my email drip campaigns, and the other things I do in my practice, he said, it's interesting. I'm finding individuals that were prospects that found me online. They downloaded a white paper, a research report, an ebook I put together. They came and watched some of my videos. They got on my email list. They started listening to my podcast. Some of them have been listening for 6, 9, 12, 18 months, but when all of a sudden their situation changes and they have a need for what I offer, because they've already got to know me, like me, trust me, and they've gotten used to me being and becoming a member of their extended family, When that situation arises, they pick up the phone and say, I need some help with this. Tell me what I need. And can we do an application tomorrow? That's the power of podcasting as a tool, as part of your marketing outreach that you're doing on a continual and regular basis. And it's part of what we teach and help financial professionals just like you put together in their practice as part of our attractional advisor model. Now, the last use I want to touch on when it comes to podcasting is influence marketing. One of the areas where you can utilize a podcast, and the top 5% do this well, is they not only do episodes where they're speaking as the authority figure and the expert. From time to time, they will invite an expert speaking into a topic that is complementary to what they do that will add value to their audience, and they invite that individual onto their podcast to speak to their audience. Now, that does two things. It introduces your audience to someone who has a complementary product or service that may add value to them, and your audience is thankful that you made that introduction. But at the same time, that individual that you are interviewing in that podcast has his or her own following. And as they come to listen to that individual speak on your podcast, they now get introduced to you and the complementary things that you can bring to that individual's clients. And it's a tremendous way to leverage the power of a podcast to really grow your following and that of your guest. Now, when it comes to putting together a podcast and actually producing a podcast, I want to give you a couple of visuals that you can think of. Many of you may know the name Rush Limbaugh in the marketplace. Love him or hate him, Rush was a phenomenal individual on the radio because he had a conversation with his audience every single day. And as a result of that, he built a very powerful cult following and gained significant influence with his audience. That's one style of podcasting that you can do. And we're going to talk about that. The other style is the Larry King style. If you were a fan of Larry King on CNN, where Larry was constantly bringing guests on his show every single week and interviewing the movers, the shakers, the power brokers, the celebrities, and they were all guests on Larry King's show. As a result, their credibility, their expertise, and their celebrity status was transferred to Larry King, and he himself became a household name. Now, both of these individuals are no longer with us, but the example that they set is extremely powerful. So when you're producing a podcast, you can do a Rush Limbaugh style where, again, you're the host. You're going to be the presenter. And what are you doing? You're having a conversation with the listening audience. You're the authority figure. You're the entertainer. And you are the celebrity. You're building your own cult following. This can be a very powerful way. Or you could go the Larry King style where you're the host and you're bringing on and interviewing special guests. Experts, authority figures, celebrities, power brokers, other people that you want to interview that have something important to say and something that would be of value to the audience. Your role there is to ask questions, be a great listener, and ask the follow-up questions you know your audience would be asking if they were there live to listen to that particular episode. So you're having a conversation with your guest. The audience is listening and learning. And you're having an opportunity to grow and expand your reach as you add value to those who are listening. Now, when it comes to formatting a podcast, and we're thinking about the type of messaging that we want to put out, it can be a topical conversation where you're speaking about income planning, estate planning, survivorship planning, business owner issues, a variety of different topics that you can rotate through on a regular basis, and we've got a significant amount of information we can help you with there. Or it can be the topical you and a guest, where you and the guest are either you're asking questions and they're answering, or it's an interactive dialogue between the two of you. You can do a Q&A where you ask your audience to submit their questions and you will answer those on a future podcast and build a podcast episode around commonly asked questions of your audience. Or you can do a Q&A with a guest, as we talked about earlier, the Larry King style of interview. You can use current events in your podcast to talk about what's going on in the world, in your local community, nationally, in the tax code, what's going on in the stock market, a variety of different current events and how they are going to impact or shape the financial decisions your customers are going to be making. And there's a variety of other ways you can format this podcast. There is no right or wrong. It's what works for you and your audience. And again, Rush Limbaugh style or Larry King style or a combination of the two. What works for you and what engages your audience is really what you want to end up with at the end of the day. And it's got to be a format that you are comfortable with. Now, let me mention up front, and anybody that's ever done a podcast knows that your first few episodes, you're horrible. You stink at what you're doing because you're learning to do something new, and it's okay. I remember Russell Brunson, who created ClickFunnels. Russell was sharing a while back about some of his very first podcast episodes. And he said, when I go back and I listen to those episodes, I think, dear Lord, why did anybody ever listen to me back then? But all of a sudden, he found his voice and he found his audience. And even his audience now goes back and listens to some of the very early issues of his podcast, and they go on the journey with him. And that's another interesting thing about podcasts. When you start, you're not necessarily going to have a lot of followers on the front end. In fact, rule of thumb in the podcast industry, until you get about 100 podcasts under your belt, you're not going to have any significant following. But there's something magic about breaking that number of 100 that when people discover you, they go back and they binge watch all the prior episodes to catch up, to get to know you. And at that point, your podcast tends to explode. Many major figures, Seth Godin is one that comes to mind, an influencer, a podcaster, one of the individuals I've had the privilege to having speak into my life. Seth will not speak on a podcast unless you've got at least 100 episodes under your belt, because he wants to know that you've got staying power as well. But one of the big things you've got to remember about a podcast, you've got to entertain your audience. It can't just be droning on with facts and figures. It can't be a sales pitch every single episode. It can't be just a topic with no fun element to it, or your audience is going to tune out and they're not going to stay engaged for very long. Now, you may be asking, hey, John, this sounds great, but what do I need to do a podcast? I don't have a ton of money. What are the most important things that I need? Well, the good news is you don't need a lot of money in terms of product and resources and tools to do a podcast. What you really need to get started is a good microphone and a good webcam if you're going to do a video style podcast. And the microphone is essential. People will put up with bad video, but they won't put up with bad audio. So I want to encourage you, there's a number of microphones out there. Most of the individuals I've talked with that are in that top 5% status, they use the Blue Yeti microphone. I'm in the process of getting one myself because I love the quality and sound of that particular instrument when you're on it. So if you're looking to make an investment, a Blue Yeti microphone is going to be around $100, maybe a little more, but you can hook that directly up to your laptop, to a computer. It's got all of the adjustments and things you need on it, a very powerful tool. Logitech makes a fantastic webcam featured here on the screen for around $50-$60. So if you've got a laptop or if you've got a desktop, webcam and a microphone, couple of $100, you're in the podcasting business. Now, you may want to invest a little more and you may want to get a nice set of headphones, because if you're utilizing your speakers as a listening device and you're doing interviews with an individual in a Q&A style, you don't want the reverberation of the speakers coming back into the microphone and creating a reverb loop. Again, bad audio, folks will not stay tuned to your podcast for very long. So headphones, if you're going to be doing Q&A style, is something you may want to consider as well. Now, another question that's often asked is, John, if I'm going to do a podcast, do I do an audio or do I do a video podcast? Well, my question back to them is always, why not both? If you're going to do it and you're going to do it well, why not do it in such a way that it can give you the opportunity to repurpose that in a number of different ways? Now, when you think about the power of podcasting and all the different media that you can take it to Facebook, to LinkedIn, to Twitter, to Instagram, to Parler, to YouTube, to Vimeo, to Gab, to USA Life, to Pinterest, to all of the other sites that are out there. Those are just a few I grabbed that are some of the more common. It can be posted to your website. It can be posted to a variety of other mediums that are out there. But to get the content to put it there, what do you need in terms of tools? Well, there are two free tools that you can utilize to actually put a podcast together. That's Zoom and a free subscription to a podcasting service called Anchor. Zoom.us to set up a free Zoom account if you don't already have one, and Anchor.fm will give you an opportunity to set up a free podcasting account where you can actually store your episodes once done and have an opportunity for people to follow that as a channel. Now, there's a couple of other tools that you may want to look at. Some people, instead of Zoom, like to use Loom, because with Loom, you can put a little round circle in the bottom where people can actually see you. And some people want folks to see them when they're doing a podcast. And if they're going to be using a PowerPoint or some type of a backdrop or images or video, and they want that small image, you can do it with Zoom with a little square. But some people like that softer round circle that Loom gives you as a resource. Again, six of one, half a dozen of the other. Pick your poison when it comes to that. But either one of those tools and resources can work for you very well. Now, some of the podcasters that I talk with in this top 5% status are spending the extra money to use a service called Riverside.fm to actually record audio/video podcast because of some of the neat tools that they have available on that site. It's a relatively inexpensive resource, but if you want to up-level the experience for yourself and your audience, you may want to take a look at Riverside.fm. You're welcome to give us a call here at Vision Advisors, and we'll have a conversation with you and talk you through that process. Now, at the end of the day, the big question is this: what do you need to get started, and what help do you need to get started? That's where we can come into play and help you have an opportunity to see success. So let me encourage you to reach out to us at Vision Advisors, 1-800-505-8489, and we'll be happy to have a conversation with you. While you're there, you can visit us at visionadvisorsinc.com, scroll to the bottom of the homepage, and you can schedule a call with any of our business consultants to talk about what we can help you there. And while you're at it, don't forget to like us and follow us on Facebook and LinkedIn, and check out our YouTube channel. Hey, it's John Terry with Vision Advisors. Thanks for joining us for this Selling Secrets of the Top 5%. We look forward to having a conversation with you on how we help you get into the powerful world of podcasting and join the top 5%. In reaching your customers and new customers every single day.